Нидерланды. Это земля удивительных контрастов. Ее визитная карточка – тюльпан, ее музыкальный стиль – хардкор. Ее футбольные фанаты – одни из самых взрывных в Европе. Сегодня наша цель – Нейминген, старейший город страны. Здесь нас ждут фанаты футбольной команды NEC, состоящей в фирме Eastside. Встречайте!
Hello everyone, today we are in the Netherlands, in the city Nijmegen, the oldest city of the country. And today's story is about NEC hooligans and our firm, the Eastside.
NEC is founded in 1900. Our stadium is located in a big park. Our capacity is 12,500. And we now play in the second division for 4 years.
Our firm is the Eastside. The Eastside was founded in 1976. And we are still strong and active. On a good day, we bring about 150 hooligans in the age between 17 and 50 years old.
Hooliganism in the Netherlands has changed over the years. From the 80s till about 2000, the Netherlands was a hooligan paradise. We could go and do what we wanted. All hooligans from all clubs could go and have a riot every match that was played. But then, things changed. There was an arranged fight between two of the biggest clubs in the Netherlands. A man got beaten with a hammer and died. There was a lot of injured people. And then our government started to make new rules and laws for matches and the way supporters had to behave and travel. Nowadays, there are more arranged fights and riots at hardcore parties and arranged wood fights.
Что ближе парням из Eastside? Старая добрая встреча в городе или укромная драка в лесу?
Those are two different kinds of fights. We have done both, but we prefer old school city fights.
In our firm, the young boys and some other lads of the group are training kickboxing. And they also do power training in our gym.
Что представляет собой околофутбольная карта Нидерландов сегодня? Кого можно назвать главными игроками на местной офф-сцене?
In our opinion, it's Utrecht, Den Haag, Feyenoord Rotterdam, and of course the Eastside Nijmegen and Ajax. Feyenoord and Ajax are the biggest clubs and have many hooligans through the country. The other clubs have more local hooligans.
You see all the clubs in the Netherlands and clubs throughout Europe as competition. No one likes us, we don't care. There's some respect for some clubs and no respect for the others.
We don't have friendships with clubs from the Netherlands.
Yes, we have a good friendship with Steaua Bucharest, Poluza Sud and the firm Shadows. We made the friendship in 2008 when we had the European match against Dinamo Bucharest. And since then, we have an international firm, the Eastside Shadows. We met in Bucharest when we played the return.
When our enemy, Dinamo Bucharest, came to the Netherlands for the first match, Dinamo attacked our family section in the stadium, and we couldn't get to them to have a fight. Instead, they attacked little children and mummies. So we had to make a statement when we went to return match in Bucharest. We went to Romania for the match and went hunting them in the city to catch our enemy. We went in a pub for some drinks, and we met some members of Steaua, the Shadows. They also are enemies with Dinamo, and they wanted to come with us to fight with Dinamo. They knew the city, and we had a good group of hooligans together. We had a massive fight in the metros, while they were riding to the Dynamo Stadium. We hunted them in the McDonald's, through the streets, and in their own stadium.
Yeah, and the guys who fight in the metros, they all had a stadium band. But in the meanwhile, in the stadium, there was a banner from the boys from Dynamo with a message. Will it be boys or girls tonight? One of our boys got pissed, kicked at the fence, and it opened. So all the Eastside hooligans in the stadium entered the security section and break out to the home section of the dogs. And we beat them good. And then the gendarmerie ended the fight and put us back in our section.
Какие самые запоминающиеся драки хулиганов из Сайт?
One of our best fights we had against Ajax. Since a long time, we were allowed to travel on our own. We departed from Nijmegen with 120 hooligans. When we arrive at the train station Duivendrecht, we get the call that the Ajax hooligans are entered the station and came to attack us. Instead, we wait for them. We cross the railway to attack the Jews. After a good fight, we all got arrested and stay at the police station for 3 days. One of our guys got jailed for 3 months. Also, against Utrecht, we had good fights. And against Den Haag at the hardcore party and in the city. And with Dynamo Bucharest, we had very good fights. We also had big fights in the city and we competed in a forest fight.
With Utrecht, we have nice fights. Utrecht came like thieves in the night to steal a flag out of our stadium. They sent a photo that they had a flag. We had to give them a message back. We made a 20-meter banner and put it on the most important tower of their city for everybody to see. Then they called us. They jeweled us to stop their buses to win our flag back when they come to Nijmegen for a cup match a couple of days later. We stopped their buses by throwing big wooden railway sleepers in front of the buses. We hit their windows with stones and bombs. The hooligans of Utrecht tried to get out of the buses, but the police fired warning shots, and then the buses had to drive away. Because we attacked them like that, we got our flag back out of respect for our action.
Also with Den Haag, we picked a date for a range fight. At that day we should meet, they cancelled it. In the evening we played a match against Dordrecht. We put out a banner with the words, "Arrange is arrange, wankers." It works, because the day after they come to our city and attack the pub where some boys of us are. Our boys went out to the pub and started to fight back. After some good punches, the lads from Den Haag ran away. And also, at the hardcore party near our city, we had a massive fight with them.
Хулиганы Нидерландов и хардкор-музыка неразделимы в глазах европейской общественности. Как так получилось?
Hardcore is a Dutch music style. The Dutch started this type of music in the 90s, the top time for hooliganism. Hardcore gives you adrenaline and pumps you up. Perfect time to start a riot. Also, the DJs were from the firm, so they attracted hooligans to the parties. Hardcore and hooliganism is a combination that gives you a kick.
Проблема любой околофутбольной сцены – полиция. Как обстоят в этом плане дела в Нидерландах?
In the Netherlands, they made laws and rules that allow the police to do what they want. One of these laws is the football law. The top 10 hooligans of all clubs are constantly being checked and observed. Phone taps are allowed and they know where we are meeting. They check our social media and even get help from snitches. The police is allowed to grab you off the street for no reason. They also closed several pubs because we went there as a group to have some drinks before the match or to watch the match.
За Нидерландами прочно закрепилась слава территории наркотической свободы. Каково отношение парней из Eastside к наркотикам?
We are a drugs capital in the world. We don't mind drugs. If you still can fight, everybody's free to do it or don't do it. We think the top three are now Germany, Russia and Poland. They are very trained, organized, have big numbers and good fights. But we always respect the English, because they started the hooliganism. In our opinion, it's of course the Eastside Nijmegen, the Politie-Zoet from Steaua Bucharest, and the Yam Yam Tipton from Wolverhampton.
Разумеется, мы не могли не спросить об отношении к русским футбольным хулиганам.
We have respect for the Russians. They are very good trained and organized hooligans. We met them in 2008 at the European Championship in the quarterfinal in Basel, Switzerland. In front of the Russian fan zone, we fight with them with a small group. It was a short but very good fight.
We are familiar with the Russian teams and firms, but we don't have any friendships in Russia.
По традиции, мы с радостью принимаем пожелания нашему каналу от наших новых друзей.
We wish the channel Okola Football TV all the best in the future. We thank them for this opportunity to give everyone an inside look in our firm.
Inside!